Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. This is another of my quick 5-minute videos where I introduce you to a technology and show you why it's so useful in teaching and learning. And today we're going to focus on Google Docs. I'm going to show you how to create a doc. I'm going to show you how Google Docs work, both from the point of view of the student and the teacher, so you can really understand exactly how they work. And then I'm going to give you a few great tips about working with Google Docs. So let's get straight into it. Now, to work with Google Docs, you do need a Google account. I've signed into my Google account. I click here, I go to the Google Drive. And Google Drive is basically like your hard disk on the cloud, on the internet. And you can see here all the folders I've created. To create a new document, all I need to do is click on New. And then simply choose the type of document. There are various ones today. We're looking at Google Docs, so I'm going to click on Google Docs. The best thing when you open up Google Docs is to immediately give your document a name so that you don't lose it. Documents are automatically saved in your Google Drive. So first of all, I'm going to prepare the document, and I'm going to put here ways to reduce pollution. And then I'm going to simply put a title here. Can you think of ways of reducing pollution? And what I'm going to do is do this as a collaborative activity so the students can just come on and write all their answers here. Now, all I need to do now is to share this document with the students. I simply share the link and the students can access the document by clicking on the link and then writing their answers. The students do not need to have a Gmail account. Sharing the document is really easy. That is getting access to the document to your students by simply clicking on this button here, Share. And then when you click on Share, the one that you want to choose is Get Shareable Link. You click here, and this gives you a link that you can then share with students. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose that the students can edit the document, they can actually write in it. I'm going to click on copy link. Now you need to share that link with the students. You might need to put it in a blog or put it in Edmodo or put it in Moodle. You need a way of sharing the link with the students. Now let me show you what happens from the student's point of view. So I'm going to log in on another account. So I'm just going to pretend I'm a student now. Obviously the student needs the address of this particular link. They click on it and the document will actually open on the student's computer, and then the students can start writing in their ideas. So I'm going to say here, reduce the number of cars. Okay, so that's my contribution, or my group's contribution, and I can obviously put some more ideas down here. Use bikes in the center of the city. Okay, etc., etc. Now let's have a look at what the teacher sees. Well, all those changes, if we just click that button down, have already been added to the teacher's document. So you can see that students can collaboratively work on a document really quickly. Now I'm going to point out in just a few tips on how you can actually do this a little bit better. But that's basically how Google Docs works. And remember that your students can add in pictures, they can add in tables, they can do all sorts of things within the document. You've got all these different things here that you would find, basically images, drawing, charts, etc., that you would find in any kind of word processing tool. So let's just give you a few tips on how to do this a little bit better. Let's imagine that you've got 5 groups. Let's imagine, for example, that you're working in the class. Well, what I would tend to do is to actually produce a little table. And I would produce a table with 5 different boxes. I move this over here, and then I'm going to tell group 1 to put their answers here, group 2 to write their answers here, group 3 to put their answers here, and etc. Now this really means that basically the document is a little bit more organized, because one of the things that happens when you work with the document is that people start writing all over the document. Then I would make this a little bit bigger so that there's plenty of space for students to work in their groups and to write their answers in. Now of course this could be done at home, because the students can all access the document from home. You might even want to make it bigger than that. It doesn't really matter if they don't complete it. So you could just make it a couple of pages long. But it simply means now if any one of the students from group 1 logs in, they know that they write their answers here. Group two write their answers here. And I often do this in class as well. And obviously, only needs one student to actually have Google Docs and to have access to a computer. That student logs in and the students discuss in groups, and the one student who's got access to the computer can write in their answers, etc., etc. So that really gives you a quick idea of just how useful and how simple it is to work with Google Docs. There is a lot more to the technology, but that is just a quick tip on why it's such a useful technology. I really hope you found those videos on Google Docs useful. Please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. There are lots more free videos. There's a very popular newsletter that you can sign up to with about 25,000 subscribers. But if you're not interested, then click here. The newsletter just updates you on all the latest videos and courses that I'm running. You've got lots of different sections here. All of the videos are free. One that you might be particularly interested in is Russell's 5-minute blog. These are very quick videos that show you different technologies that you might be interested in using in your teaching and learning. Whenever you click on a video, please remember to watch the video full screen. It's a much more enjoyable experience when you click on the button to just watch the video full screen. And that way you see the video much more clearly. The other thing on the website that's very popular is the top 20 videos, where I give a list of the most popular technologies on the website that teachers are using and giving me feedback on. Finally, if you really want to follow what I'm doing, another good place to go is to go to YouTube, because on the YouTube channel I add even more videos. So please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you're interested. And thank you very much.